Hey, everybody.
Wow.
Welcome back to Tokyo Indie Fest. You're probably thinking that, like, you know, the show's over. It's not. I just want to let you guys know that we're trying very hard to keep the show rolling. It's just sometimes the setup takes a little bit longer than we think. You know, I did have to tweet some things out there. I was able to meet the Sony PR rep who did a lot of marketing for Bloodborne.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll have to play that game.
Oh, so man. Good.
Oh, man. It's... No, I've been busy developing my own game, and I can't... Oh, man.
Yeah, no, I mean, I totally understand. Yeah. Which, by the way, maybe I should introduce who I'm talking to here.
All right.
Because you know me, I'm Man from Man vs. Game. I am joined here by Ojiro-san.
Hello.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
Yes. And we are here to talk about your game, Downwell.
Yep.
So,
we are.
Well, I mean, where do we start? Just really quick, can you tell me, like, what is Downwell?
Okay, so Downwell is a game about going down a well, wearing guns for shoes. It's designed to be played on mobile smartphones, and the objective is to just keep going down. Right?
Sweet. Yeah. And is there a score system? Is there?
Not at the moment, but you do collect these gems that the enemies drop, and you can use that. It's basically a currency to buy stuff at the shops that appear occasionally.
Okay, and so that in turn gets used to make you more powerful and
right. And
just keep the keep going down the well.
That's right.
Cool. I just want to say we'll be taking a look at the game like very soon, soon enough. Okay, let's just calm down, everybody. I am just you're a very interesting individual. And Downwell has recently gotten a lot of media attention.
Yeah, it sure has.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's
still unreal. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a beautiful game.
Thank you very
much. I'm just wondering, can you tell us a little bit about, like, how did you get into game development?
Right. Okay. So I'll try to keep it short, but I don't come from a programming background or anything. I was still in college last year, and I was actually studying music. And like opera singing and stuff.
Really?
But, yeah.
Wait a minute.
I was.
Wait a minute. Ojiro, you're studying opera singing in college.
I was, yeah.
Wow.
But the thing is, I really wasn't interested in that at all, right? I was doing it reluctantly, kind of. And all the while that I was in college, I just kept on playing video games, right? And it's all I've ever wanted to do with my life. And I really wanted to make video games ever since I was young.
Yeah.
But I thought would be way too hard. Like, I didn't know what programming was.
Yeah.
It just looked really difficult, so I didn't even try. But
after
studying opera singing and stuff for 4 years, I started like wondering, what am I going to do with my life? And
I'm so glad that we are, that I asked this question, because like it blows my mind that you studied and not only that you were studying opera singing, but reluctantly, like somebody was making you study opera singing. Was it?
Yeah, it's super strange.
Were your parents just like, you're going to be an opera singer?
No, not really. No. So I wanted to do something music related, right?
Mm.
And one of my teachers at my high school, well, not really high school, but yeah, my school, suggested that I start out with singing because it's relatively easy to get into.
Okay.
So yeah, I just started like that, and it turned out that I was relatively decent at singing. So I just continued on with it.
I'm trying very hard not to ask you to like sing a little opera.
That's not gonna happen. No way.
I knew I had a feeling that was not gonna happen. Because you'd lose your indie, cred right there. Like,
might be way too weird.
Yeah. No, if anything,
let's just keep it video games.
Exactly. Let's just stick to the games. That's very cool. And so you went through all that, and then you just what was it that finally made you say, like, you know what? Because like you said, it seemed like game development would be too hard.
Right.
Was it just like after those 4 years of opera singing, you were just like, you know what? I'm going to try it.
Right. So in my fourth year in college, I was at this point where the next year I would be graduating, right?
Yeah.
and then I would need to get a job. I would need to like start earning money to make a living, right?
Yeah. Scary.
It's scary, yeah sure. So I just wanted to, I didn't want to regret anything in my life, right? I just decided that I will take the shot because I've always wanted to make video games. How hard could it be now that like people are using Unity and stuff?
Yeah.
And like, yeah, and my favorite game developer, like Flambier, they're using GameMaker, right?
Yeah. Yeah,
that was actually a huge reason why I started like playing around with GameMaker myself and found that it wasn't as hard as I imagined it would be.
Yeah.
And yeah, I just worked on it as hard as I could because I just didn't want to do something that I didn't want to do as a job.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, yeah, that was a weird way of phrasing it, but yeah.
I totally understand it, actually.
Yeah.
But it's so funny to hear you mention Flambier as like, so they're probably a big inspiration for you.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah. Well, you can see it in Downwell, honestly, because it's, you know, it's, I would definitely put it right in the, with their kind of games where it's you know, game based around like a pretty simple mechanic,
right,
but executed like very well. And it has tons of strategy, you know, layered within that very simple mechanic.
Right.
So, but
I take so much inspiration from their games. So I think as soon as you look at it, I think you could tell maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I mean, but you know, and that's the thing is like it's still like very very different. You know, it's
right.
You know, it's still very much like your style. Should we take a look at the game?
Maybe, yeah.
I think so. I think the viewers, like, there's only so much blathering that they can stand before they just start to riot. So let's take a quick look here at Downwell.
Okay.
And there it is. Oh, look at that. I love the screen setup.
Oh, cool.
And I love how, like, at the events, you always use a monitor that's, like, turned on its side. because it's because of that
catches attention, right?
Yeah. And it's just more like a vertical setup. And here we go. And now we have Bree with the event. She's going to hold the microphone. She's actually off camera.
My disembodied floating arm.
And there's Bree. That's Bree holding the mic. So thank you very much, Bree. But
so I'll stop playing, I guess.
There you go. Yeah, please do. And so, and there it is, the title screen. Tokyo IndieFest 2015 build.
Yeah, so the game begins with, as soon as you drop down this well. The main mechanic is you have this thing called the gun boots on your feet and you shoot out of your legs, right?
Yeah.
As I said before, the objective is to just keep going down.
Yeah. So as you are defeating enemies, they're dropping those gems.
Yep.
And you've got
42. So you can use that to buy stuff at shops. As well as that, if you collect a lot of them fast enough, you enter this powered up state, which I did right now.
Yeah.
So you now see these like red trails following the player.
Yeah.
And the bullets are more powerful now.
I just want to say, like the art design, like the style, like the very like minimalist approach. I love it. Like it's just, I was telling somebody, it reminds me of, you know. You know, except for the red, I guess, it reminds me of like a Game Boy kind of aesthetic.
Right. Yeah, so one reason why I kept the color palette to like the limited, like all black and white and red, is because I have been developing this game alone for very long.
Mm.
And since I'm doing all the graphics and stuff by myself, I didn't want to take so much time on these graphical assets.
Yeah.
So I just kept everything simple, like black and white, because it wouldn't take much of my time.
All the shotgun boots.
Right.
I love those. Almost like a spread gun.
Yeah. It's everyone's favorite weapon, right? So every time you beat a level, you get to choose from these sets of random free upgrades.
Mm.
And,
that reminds me of another game.
Nuclear Throw.
Yes.
Yeah.
That Flambier influence, which you know what?
Right.
I love
just it. Just blatantly copying it.
Well, it's, you know, if something works well, it works, you know.
Right, it does. So I'll just go with gem power. Oh, I should explain the mechanic actually. So this, the white bar that at the top is basically the ammo you have left. And as you see, if I shoot, it depletes, but every time I land, it recharges. Oh, right?
Okay.
So if I try to shoot more, it just like doesn't let me.
Oh, and then now you have the laser. Okay.
Yeah.
So you got a few more shots. Which that, for me, that seems like that'd be much more of a liability.
Right.
Or it just, I mean, my aim would be so bad, but but I see the benefit there. Oh wow. See, another move that you can do that I didn't realize before, but like you're able to like just basically like Mario like jump on enemies' heads.
Stomp on enemies too.
Yeah.
But you can't stomp on any enemy. You can stomp on most enemies, but occasionally there are these like red-looking ones. Mm. You can't stomp on those.
Oh, okay.
Oh, here's a shop now.
There you go.
You can buy stuff here. Like basically in healing item or battery, which is the ammo.
Okay.
And the value set, which is like a mix of the three. I guess I'll get this.
Must have bundle, nice.
Yeah.
Hey, that shopkeeper is very happy with what he does.
Yeah, he is, but if I get behind the counter, he gets angry.
Oh, no, he's not like that.
Yeah, let's not anger him too much.
Okay, cool. Can you like tell me? Can you like shoot? Can you kill the shopkeep?
Yes, I think. So there is a stealing mechanic in the game where,
really?
Can steal from the shopkeeper, but he will get super angry.
Okay.
And he's really tough to beat. So
yeah, interesting. I wasn't sure. I wasn't sure if you were gonna like reveal the information, but that is. Very cool.
Well,
just noticing the way that he got angry when you got near the items.
Yeah.
It made me wonder.
Oh, so which one should I go? I'll go with this one, which is, as it says, stomping enemies will cause a blast. Now
that's awesome.
I'll try to show you.
Yeah. We still got that power up from the last area. Wow, now what is that? Oh!
Okay, so like these red guys, you can't stomp on them. And that red eyeball thing.
Okay.
Too.
The side area. Machine gun. This
right.
is another item that I like.
Right.
Executed very well.
Thank you.
And, so, I was gonna ask as well, like, is there an end to Downwell? Does this well go on forever?
So yeah, there will be an end. Like, it's not done yet, but
yeah.
I'm planning on having like a boss, like a final boss at the end, and there will be an end. But maybe, yeah, I'm playing with the idea of having like a loop after beating the final boss, like Nuclear Throne.
yeah.
So maybe it'll be endless that way.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That's cool. I love that idea. He's got no charge. Oh.
Oh crap.
Oh, there he goes. Turn your life bar up there. You got about half life. Confirmed.
Oh shit.
Oh no. But that's fine. If you want to say shit on this broadcast, you can.
Sorry about that.
Shit.
Okay, so oh, which one should I go with? I'll get the apple because I'm at low health.
It's a good plan.
Right.
It's a good plan.
So now I'm in this different area, the dungeons, which will have like different sets of enemies and like these spiky plates.
Oh, nice. I haven't even seen this area. See, because I'm not very good. I haven't.
Right. No, not many people are. Not yet.
Not yet. Exactly. And that's a game that. The more time you put into it, the better you'll get.
Right.
Which I guess could really be like every game ever made. I try to say things that I think sound, you know, very poignant and deep. They're not. It's not.
They are.
No.
Sure.
Back to the laser.
Oh, man.
Woo! 3 combo. One thing I was going to ask as well, now, is the layout of the well, is it kind of like procedurally generated, very random?
Oh yeah, that's right. It's randomly generated every time, so no trip down will be the same.
Yeah, which is awesome. makes for very, very addictive games, very addictive gameplay.
Oh man, I'm weakly focused on just like making it far.
No, you should. I mean, that's it's great. Like the further you get, like the more, you know. Because again, we have plenty of time.
Oh yeah, sure.
2-1 cleared. Beautiful.
Yeah, I'll get the drone. It's really helpful.
Yeah. Is there, I mean, besides Vlambeer, is there any particular like games that you were inspired by, like with the sort of like the art design?
Oh, Spelunky for sure.
Really nice.
Yeah. So basically, when I started to make this game, I wanted to make a Spelunky-like game that you could play on smartphones. And it really ended up being super different from Spelunky, but yeah, still like the platformer idea.
Yeah.
And, like, just the fact that you just keep going downwards is kind of from Spelunky.
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely.
And the shopkeeper.
Yeah, absolutely. And then angering the shopkeep and all that.
Yeah.
And that's, and it's done. Right, it's over. Wow. I feel somehow responsible. Do you mind? could I take a
sure? Okay. Go ahead.
There you go. Okay. Yeah. Right. Now Bree is coming around right now to hold my microphone, and so we're gonna give Bree. It's a very big table we have here at Twitch. Okay. Thank you, Bree, very much. Appreciate it. All right. So here, I got it. My face was out of the shot. Okay. There. So there you go. Better. Okay. This is great. Okay, I'm having a blast. Here we go. Quick restart. And there's really just the one mechanic. The jump and shoot is the same button.
So the game was designed to be able to be played on smartphones, so the control scheme is super simple.
Which, okay, here we go. Now, what the F? Oh, here we go. And it is quite simple.
Yeah, so the smartphone version will have three on-screen buttons, which will be left, right, and jump. And the jump button acts as shooting as well. So while you're in the air, if you press jump, you'll be shooting.
Yeah.
Which is what's happening with the pad as well right now.
I was gonna ask you, do you when you play, do you use the analog stick or the D-pad?
The D-pad.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, the D-pad is more precise for these kind of games, I feel.
Yeah.
Personal preference, but yeah.
And it's pretty, you know. Actually, the D-pad for the Xbox One controller is not so bad.
Yeah, it does.
Certainly better than the 360. Oh, boom.
Way better.
Yeah, way better. Oh, and I got the power. I finally got the power up. Okay. Oh, and I missed the room.
Oh, no.
What am I doing? What am I doing, Ojito? Okay.
Also, I forgot to explain. Maybe next time you come across the room, I'll talk about it, but yeah.
Okay. Let's see. Oh, blast module. Shooting dead bodies causes them to explode.
Yeah, that's a good one, though. Actually.
Hello, I'm a drone. Oh. I'll go with the recommendation. You can't, go against that. Okay. Beautiful. Beautiful. And there's that. Yeah.
Right.
Wow, that is pretty powerful. And I am just missing another room. What am I doing? Okay. Wanted to,
yeah, don't miss the next one.
Yeah, please, God, don't. Just don't do it. Which, by the way, Bree, you're doing a heck of a job holding that mic. And I am now dead!
Damn.
That's, wow, real sadness. And I'm covering up the bottom of the mic like an idiot. I was going to say, I totally get, like, the, I love how the way the screen is vertical,
right.
You know, and so I see now where you said you basically wanted to make like a Spelunky game for, like a mobile phone.
Yeah.
Which is awesome. A mobile phone. Oh, God. Do you mind if I try again? I would love to try again.
As many times as you want.
It's a very, like, we were just talking about like how addictive these kind of games can be, and I feel I could do a lot better than, where did I get 1-2, 1-3?
I think you got to 1-2 right now, yeah.
Okay, that's pathetic. That is absolutely pathetic. So, Bree, if you wouldn't mind.
There we go. Okay, we've got the mic.
Beautiful. I love that. Okay. Now, so it just, see, my thing is, oh my God, that's not a good start. Okay. Okay, let's just take it easy here. Take it easy.
Alright.
Okay, beautiful, beautiful. Okay. So I'm going for the stomp. Okay.
Alright.
We're good.
So, one thing I forgot to explain is that once you enter that red void thing,
yeah.
One that you entered through, like that circle thing,
yeah.
Time stops.
Oh.
Yeah, I think you'll see that maybe in the next one, but
just stomp him.
No, you can't stomp on the red ones.
Yeah, see that was a nice setup though. It's like I was trying to stomp the, well, quite frankly, they remind me of Metroids, but they're more like bubbly things.
So go out of there slowly.
Oh.
Yeah, so you see that the enemies have stopped moving, and even the dead body is floating.
Look at
yeah,
that.
So that's what I wanted to explain.
Beautiful. Oh, and I cannot, for the life of me.
All right.
Okay. Here we go. See, I just gotta practice. That's all it is. That's all it is. Don't get upset.
Oh, you're doing pretty great, actually.
Yeah. See, thank you. I need that. Oh my God.
Oh no.
See the frog. I don't know why, but the frog reminds me of Blaster Master. Okay, so the drone consume some dead bodies to gain health. That could be nice. Rest in pieces. Shooting dead bodies causes them to explode. I'm gonna try the knife and fork just to see.
That's a good one as well.
Yeah, I could use the health, I think. Now, if I could. Hold on.
But you will need to eat a lot of them, like about 20 dead bodies, so it might take some time. But
that's what I was figuring. Oh God, eat them. Okay.
Going to the room.
Yeah, I gotta do it.
All right.
Okay, I got it. Machine gun. Okay.
Machine gun.
Beautiful.
So every time you get those weapon swaps, you will get either 1 HP or more ammo.
Okay.
So the one you got right now, it gave you 2 extra batteries, which is the ammo, basically.
Okay.
So you start out with 8 ammo, but right now you have 10. That's
Now I'm trying. I just want to eat dead bodies. That's all I want. Oh, tell me. No, that wasn't it. Okay. You do have to eat a lot of dead bodies. Which is... might sound kind of morbid. If we weren't playing a video game.
Maybe.
Oh, okay, there we go. So we got the blast power. Oh.
Oh yeah, you got the HP.
Yes!
From eating.
And now I bet I'm going to lose it like immediately. Okay, good. Okay, please. Okay. Well, I just need more dead bodies. Just put the dead bodies ever.
No.
Yeah, I knew it. Okay, we're fine. Okay, and that's it. Wow.
Oh damn.
Was that? I don't even remember. Was that 1-2?
Oh, that was that 1-2.
Oh my God.
Can't seem to get past 1-2.
Are we? And unfortunately, we can't see the chat right now.
Right.
Unfortunately or fortunately.
Oh man, I don't wanna see many people. Like, yeah. Talking about shit.
Let me just ask, Gunrun, which by the way, Gunrun is running the show and he's doing a heck of a job. Is there any interest in the chat in seeing me try it one more time? I want to try and get past 1-2. I also don't want to hold up the show with my stubbornness. So we'll just wait a little minute or
sure.
A moment. Is in yes? Okay, good. All right.
Go ahead.
You might breathe. Thank you.
1-2 yes, the 1-2 challenge.
I must get past. So here we go. Okay, get your game face on.
All right, be careful.
Yeah. I think you know what happens to me in games? I get so caught up in killing everything. Like I can't like get through an area without killing it. So.
Yeah, going past them is one option.
Yeah. See, I also want those crystals. I want to get the power.
Okay.
There you go. First room. That's good. Now this is what I'm talking about. Right here. Yes. Plus 100. Okay. Beautiful. Yeah. It has a very good feel. The game.
Thank you.
It's just there's something endlessly satisfying about shooting downward with your gun boots and destroying the enemies.
Oh,
yes.
Okay. No, this is a good run, I think.
Yes. This is the run. This to earn right here.
Earn.
Yeah. Earn it. Oh, and the frog.
All right. Okay.
No, did you see that? Wow. Bam.
That's good.
Okay. I'm feeling good. Feeling the flow. Kind of flowing.
Oh,
look at that.
Okay. That was quick.
This is the one. I'm getting better. Masochist Candle. Longer state of invincibility when taking damage. Shooting at bodies causes them to explode, and a hot casing, bullet casings deal damage. Wow. What's funny is, like, I hadn't even noticed that there were bullet casings, like going out. Yeah, like, there's so much, you know, madness on the screen.
Right.
All right, let's try Rest in Pieces.
Yeah, that's the best one, I think, yeah.
Okay, there you go. I chose wisely. Okay, beautiful. Oh, yeah. Oh, with the shotgun especially? Oh, this is the one. Okay.
Right.
Well,
okay.
I don't think I should have taken that, honestly.
God!
It's fine. Okay, there we go. All right, see? Okay,
no,
this
no.
is... Yeah, everything, like, falls apart for me in 1-2. I gotta just get it together here.
You're gonna be okay.
Yeah, we're gonna be fine.
Yep.
Everything's fine.
See, oh, there's the shop.
Okay,
right.
Okay. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Let's talk to this guy. Buy heals your soul. That would be very handy. Plus one charge for gun boots, 2 batteries. You know, it
you
really,
should heal your soul.
I really should.
Yeah.
And it makes me sad that I have to. Like, I really wish I could just, you know, get the power ups, but I gotta play it safe with my fledgling abilities. Oh yeah. There you go. Oh boy. So,
okay. How'd you get through that?
You know, I.
Wow.
What can I say? I just video game master. Okay. I learned so quickly. That's what it is.
Right.
Oh god. You know what? I'm just going.
Oh.
I'm just going. Because right now.
Okay.
I'm not worried about the score or anything like that. Because like I said, it's basically just money to buy power ups, right?
That's right.
And you know, it'd be nice to get my combo back.
Okay,
but
so you got the 1-3.
Hey!
Yay!
It's a happy day here at Tokyo Indie Fest. I don't need to gain 4. Okay, shop at... Okay, sorry, 10% discount. Sucks in nearby gems. Nice. That's
nice.
Very nice. I love that. Love to suck. Rightio. Okay, there you go.
Oh.
Now, I really... Yeah, that's what I need to be doing more of, is like the stomping, the head stomp.
Right. But don't stomp the red ones.
Yeah, the...
Right.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, I just gotta get... Okay. Yeah. I can see... my God. Okay, okay.
You only have one left.
Yeah. Now, how did that happen? I went from like... Okay, well, here it is. The save. Oh, no. Not, I don't need more money. Look at that! No, that's random.
Oh yeah, that's the health and the triple shot.
Wow! Okay, beautiful.
So you might have a chance.
Oh,
right.
Wow! Oh, now this is the best gun. This is the best gun. I'm calling out right now. Are you kidding me right now? Get out! Bria, how's your arm doing? Are you good? Okay. I know, I'm sorry. It looks like I'm just gonna be playing for a while here, is what I'm saying. So... Whoa.
Oh, that was close.
Yeah.
Yeah, shit.
Oh, yeah. Okay, and they do. They will just follow you to the ends of the game. Oh,
well, it's the end of the level, so...
Yeah.
Oh, so you got to the second area.
Congrats. Nice! 1-3 clear. So each area has 3 levels?
Yep.
Nice.
Oh, man, this is the run.
This is... Okay, shop start at 10%, longer state of invisibility. Let's try this drone. I don't think I've had a drone yet. I love the random upgrades. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's it right there. Wow, look at that. Charge up. And I don't even know. Oh, that spikes. Oh, that's...
Well, you did get pretty far.
I did. You know what? I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that run.
Yeah, not many people at the show has managed to get to the second area. So
the difficulty ramps up pretty quick.
It really does.
Which, you know, like 1-1 is sort of like your introduction to the game,
right.
And then 1-2 is like, okay, now, like the real game kind of starts.
Right. That's right.
And I'm sure, like, what you're thinking is, I'm sure, like, I haven't even seen, like, you know, what difficult is in this game yet. Well,
right.
Like, I died immediately in 2-1. So.
Yeah, I'm planning on making it pretty hard. But
that's
yeah.
good. I mean.
But fair.
Yeah.
Like, hard in a fair way.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think, if I would have just managed, I think, to use my head stomps better, or really, it's sad that it all came down to me not knowing that that block was a spike block. If I had been paying attention, I would have known. But well, I just want to say, man, Downwell, awesome game.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank
you. Like, so what platforms? platforms is this going to be available on?
So I'm planning on iOS, Android, and PC.
Okay, sweet.
I'm working with Devolver Digital on this game.
Really?
Yeah, so they'll be releasing it on Steam. Yeah.
Love those guys. That's so cool.
Love those guys too. They're pretty cool, right?
Yeah, they're pretty cool. They really are. Like they're about as rock star as you can get in the game development.
Yeah, they
industry.
Sure are. They yeah. Are.
And that's very cool that you're working with them. Wow. And I'm sorry if you already answered, but about like when were you shooting for release?
Sometime within this year.
Okay.
Around summer, I hope.
Sure.
Yeah.
Which, that's totally cool. I always say, like, take the time, whatever, however long you need to make the game you want. I was just thinking, like, how is it working with Devolver? I was just going to joke about them, like pressuring you to finish the game, but...
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure they're not like that at all.
They're really mean people, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
They have been really great to me. So as I said before, I haven't been making games for long. I just graduated out of college and made this small game. And they took notice, and they've been helping me ever since. Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, without them, I probably wouldn't be here right now.
Oh, really?
Seriously, yeah.
Like, do you mean here, like, at the Tokyo Indie Fest?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And here at like Twitch and like stuff, getting coverage and stuff. Yeah. Like, it's all thanks to Devolver, really.
Awesome. Yeah, they are definitely cool guys.
Yeah, they're doing a great job of like introducing small indie guys to like the bigger market and stuff.
Absolutely. Like giving them like these huge like, you know, worldwide releases, which is so cool to see.
Yeah, and they're great.
I really hope to see like more of that happening for like the Japanese.
Yeah, I really hope so too.
Yeah, are you very like involved in the Japanese indie scene here?
So there's not much of a scene yet in Japan. Well, surely there have been just like there have been many people making games as a hobby, but they haven't been making it to like. Sell it or become like or like live off of it.
They've
just been doing it for hobby, and not many people have done it to make a living. So I'm hoping Japan would have like more of like the Western indie style, kind of like just live off of making games and like selling it off Steam and stuff.
Totally. I feel you know sometimes there's this attitude that, you know, if you strive to make any money off of, you know, the art that you create or what you enjoy doing, you know, that you're like a sellout, or, you know, that you, you know, you're not doing it for the love of the thing or whatever, which, you know, I personally disagree with. I think,
right.
You know, it's, you can certainly get too caught up in that, you know, in that aspect of it. But, you know, like the guy that I interviewed just before you, Tamura-san, he's the guy who he made that a walk through an old school virtual reality experience, really. I was kind of asking him if he had any plans to try and, you know, distribute the game or sell the game, and he was just like, no. He's like, it's just a you know, like a side project that he worked
right.
on. It's a little easier to understand with, you know, a project like that, maybe that.
Yeah, I guess because it's been like that for very long in Japan.
Mm.
So people are reluctant to sell it because it might seem weird, right?
Yeah.
But really, like everyone in the world is doing it.
Yes, and we want to buy it. Like, like if it's a good game, or you know, if it's an interesting experience, like you know, people have no problems with paying money to, you know, to play the game, or you know, it's your, I don't know, I just, bottom line is I think people should be paid for their work, and you know, it's not a bad thing. So
no, it's not.
We were on the same page. We're just,
right.
Yeah. Is there anything that I'm forgetting to tell people about with Downwell? Is there anything that you wanted to make sure that people know about Downwell?
No, I don't think so. I think we've showed enough, right?
You know, I'm just killing time right now.
Okay. Sure.
So Downwell, we can expect it hopefully sometime this year.
Yep.
Talk about OS, Android, and on PC.
PC, yeah.
Ojiro, I can't wait to buy this game. I can't wait to play it.
I can't wait to finish developing it.
Yeah.
I'll try my hard. I'll try my best to finish it as soon as possible, but yeah.
Well, what you have so far is absolutely just magnificent.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So thank you very much for joining me on the stream here.
Thank you.
And have a good rest of the show, and I'm sure I'll see you walking around here later.
You will.
All right, man.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. We're gonna take another break. We're gonna find something to do. I'm gonna just hold on to this microphone, and I'll start interviewing people out there. We'll do something because I know the breaks are. They go on quite a bit. But thank you, everybody, for your patience. And thanks for watching, everybody. We'll be right back here with more. Coming to you live in Akihabara, Tokyo, Japan, for the Tokyo Indie Fest right here on Twitch. we are back yet again here at Tokyo Indie Fest. I am joined by Jeff is back, and Ojiro-san. Ichijo. Oh, okay.
You just did Ojiro.
What's that?
You just did Ojiro-san.
Oh, I just did Ojiro. Okay, well, that's why I thought your name was that. Okay, wow. It's been a long day. Well, thank you very much for joining me here. Yes. How are you enjoying the show so far?
Tokyo Indie Fest wa ma dou desho ka?
Sugoku tanoshii desu ne. Iroiro na hito ga boku no game wo mii ni kite kureru shi, iroiro iken wo itte kureru desu. Motto kou shita hou ga ii toka. Sore ga sugoku tanoshii desu.
It's been a lot of fun. A lot of people have come to see my game and they've offered me a lot of opinions and strong feedback on how I can improve it.
Oh, cool. Most of it good, I hope.
まあ、いい、フィードバックはいいフィードバックとなるといいんですけど。はい。
そうですね。こういう人に遊んでほしいっていうイメージがあります。その人から僕はもっとこういうふうにしてほしいっていうふうに言われるのがやっぱり嬉しいので。
So I have a certain, audience in mind when I was making this game, and to have those people come and play it and give me, you know, opinions on how I can improve it has been really great.
Yeah. And your game is a very interesting game. When we saw it on the floor, I just, you know, we just knew we had to get you on the stream.
で、このゲームは非常に面白いですね。フロアで見たときに、なんかぜひこの Twitch stream に見せたいと思ったんですけど。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Yes. Also, I just wanted to ask really quick. I see your the name, your developer name, your company is. Throw the warped code out?
I think it's a very strange name.
Yeah. Yes, it is. Is it, was there a reason why you went with that, or is there a story behind it?
その名前を選んだ理由とかはありますでしょうか？
僕は80年代の UK とか US のシンセポップが好きです。で、その大好きなバンドのアルバム名をもじって作っています。変えて。そのアルバム名はSue the Warped Wheeled Out なんですね。
So there was a band back in the 80s that I listened to a lot, and one of their CDs was called Throw the Warped Wind Out. And so I kind of based it on that and created. Wheel. Throw the wheel out. Warped wheel out.
Oh, okay. Wow.
失礼しました。
That's cool. That's very cool.
素晴らしいですね。
Well, shall we take a look at your game? Your game is called Back in 1995.Can you tell us just real quick what kind of a game is Back in 1995?
ちょっと見てみますけど、Back in 1995ってどのようなゲームでしょうか？
簡単に言うと、90年代のプレイステーション1、セガサターンの時の 3D アドベンチャーゲームを再現するゲームです。
So put simply, I wanted to recreate the feel of a 90s game that would have been on the PlayStation 1 or Sega Saturn.
Oh wow, and I think you have done that very well when we take a look at the game here.
それはよくできたと思いますし、ちょっと見てみましょうか。
Yes, so shall we play just a little bit of it?
ちょっとプレイしましょうか。Okay, let's go.
誰が?
Who will play?
Shall I play?Sure, I can play. Sure. Yeah, I'll play. ちょっとマイクを。はい、お願いします。This control? Okay.
で、これは95年のゲームなので、操作方法はこれですね。
So because this is a game from 1995, these are the controls here.
Without an analog.Just digital moves.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, thank you. Arigato. Yeah, I cannot use the analog stick because back at the first generation PlayStation, there was no analog stick.
So, right. 最初のプレイステーだとアナログスティックはなくて、だから方向キーとかは使いますよね。
そう、はい、そうです。それだけです。デジタルの方向キーを使います。
Okay, yeah, just the D-pad.
じゃあ、始めましょう。Here we go. 日本語、I'll try English.
まあいいや、はい。英語版は自分で翻訳したので変な英語になっています。
So I made the English version myself. There may be some strange English in there.
But that would be just like, I think, like some earlier games from 1995.
でもそれでも90年代のゲームですね。
そうですね。それ偶然そうなったかも。
That's probably by coincidence, but that's how it happened.
Yeah. Pick up. Here we go. Awesome. Okay, there we go. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a tough job holding these microphones for me. There we go.
マイクを持つのは結構大変な仕事です。
And so the controls, just so you guys know, basically if you've played like a Resident Evil game, the controls are very the same. Oh my god! I am... Okay, good. Okay. I was worried that I was not hitting him.
Woodburst. 彼はあまり強くないので、あのモンスターに3回か4回ぐらい噛まれると死にます。
So the main character is not very strong. If the monster bites him, say, 3 or 4 times, he dies.
Really? Okay. And again, just the controls, like it's right and left, turn your character, and up will be forward, and then you know, down is backward. So again, if you've played a Resident Evil game, it's very, very similar.
Biohazard に似てるですね、そのコントロールに。
Biohazard とあと Silent Hill、Alone in the Dark のこれをイメージしてます。
So I built this with the inspiration of Resident Evil, Silent Hill, and Alone in the Dark.
Yes, which I love that in, if you didn't know, Resident Evil in Japan is called Biohazard. That confused me a lot. Oh, use an spare key at back of compressor unit.
It's a little embarrassing.
It's great. It's wonderful.
素晴らしいと思います。
Yeah.
日本のゲームを英語版が出たときにちょっと変な英語の時がある。それに偶然近くなったかもしれないですね。
So back then, you know, games that were developed in Japan and released in the West did tend to have some strange English in them. I think by coincidence, I've recreated that as well.
Yes, and that's exactly what I was thinking. It's
その通りです。
Yes. Using the spear key in the back of the computer. Okay. So
there's still some Japanese left in there.
Yeah.
That's a miss on the part of the localization team.
That's why. Oh, up the stairs, up the stairs. Hi. Go up. The loading, I love that. The spinning
disc. いいですね、その loading screen.
Yeah. Good. Got it. Okay. Wood waste. Give me the wood waste. Wood waste or... I wonder what I use the wood waste for. Oh, no. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna...
Go around the back of that machine there.
Okay, okay. He's running. Unknown key? Unknown's key.
Spelling miss.
That's a bit unknowns. Of a spelling miss as well.
I love it. Oh, God. Where are we going? Where's the camera? Okay. And just like Biohazard or Resident Evil, there's a fixed camera. Yeah, in the room. Use the compress key.
この操作方法はキャンコントロール。日本語だとラジコン操作。英語だとタンクコントロール。
Yeah, so in English, I believe you call this tank controls. In Japanese, we would call it like an RC type of control.
Oh, okay. It cheated. Oh, man.
Zurui.
Yeah, zurui yo. I think I can hold it. Oh, you good? Okay, you good. Continue back. Would you care to play?
ちょっとプレイしますか?見せてください。
Thank you very much. Now that I've shown how not to play.
じゃあ正しくない遊び方を見たので見せたので今回は開発者を
このゲームは難しく作ったので僕もクリアできない時があります。
So I made this game with difficulty in mind, high difficulty in mind, and not even I can really clear it.
Really? That's. There it is.
Boosh!
Oh.
上に上がってすぐ鍵を取りに。
I'm going to go right up and get that key.
I still.
Okay.
I can't get over how great. Oh, oh, oh. There he goes. Slam it. Bow. Nice.
That's very... あと今1回噛まれたので、あと3回は大丈夫。
So I've been bitten once. I've got about three opportunities left.
Okay. So you got the key. I was trying to figure out what...
遊びながらお話しすると、いろんなインディーゲームはレトロスペクティブなゲームがありますけども、でもこの32ビットのゲームはまだ誰も作ってないですよね。
So, in a lot of these...like retro games that are coming out, you see a lot of really classic styles, but no one has really moved to the 32-bit era yet in indie gaming.
It's true, and that's what I think was so, you know, interesting about your game, because you hit that style like so spot on.
私もそう思いますので、それがこのゲームの魅力だと思います。
このゲームは Unity でできています。
This game is built in Unity.
Yeah.
Unity の、会社の人に見せたら、おかしいって言われました
ね。So this is the end of the game. It's built in Unity, and when I showed it to the people at Unity, they said, this is really weird.
Oh, really? This is weird.
Insane.
Oh, yeah? Really? That seems a little harsh.
ちょっと苦しいですね。
難しい。
It's a bit, it's hard to say.
Throw the warp code out, I love it.
ところが強かったってことですか。
It was a little bit strong, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I think so too. I mean, because I appreciate this style of game. But I liked that final line that said, come and find me.
Ah, このゲームも好きですけど、最後のセリフが、come and find me というの、まあ、来て、見つけてくださいっていうのあって、それは何なんでしょう？
このゲームの最後の目的は、タワーに。たどり着いて謎を解くことです。で、ユーザーは、あ、じゃあプレイヤーは、タワーに行く理由を途中でだんだん分かっていく、理解していく。なミステリーゲームですね。
So the ultimate goal is to reach that tower that you saw in the final scene there. And the player will unfold some of the mysteries surrounding the story as they go toward that tower.
Cool, very cool. Do you know...In terms of like continuing to develop the game, do you know when we can expect to see the finished game?
じゃあ開発について聞きますけど、リリースの予定はいつでしょうか？
2015年の冬ですね。
In the winter of 2015.
Really? Very cool. Well, I definitely look forward to seeing the finished game. Do you know, is the game going to be available anywhere?
完成版を楽しみにしていますけど、その完成版はいつ、まあ、冬なんですけど、そのプラットフォームとかは、
PC と Mac は発売します。で今、プレイステーション4と、あと、プレイステーションビーターですね、を他の会社と相談して、トライ、決めているところです。まだ途中です。
So we're going to sell it on Windows and Mac, and we're also in talks with Sony for PlayStation 4 and Vita.
That would be very cool. Oh, nice.
Vita version はこのように動くものができているんですけども、でもこの PlayStation Mobile というサービスはなんと終わってしまったんですね。なのでこのバージョンは発売できないんです。
So here's how it controls on the Vita. We're planning to release it for the PlayStation Network. Unfortunately, not the PlayStation Network, the PlayStation Mobile Network. Unfortunately, that has come to an end.
Oh, really? Oh, no.
なので今は、Vita、普通の、PlayStation Network の Vita と PS4 発売してくれる会社を探しています。
So we're looking for a company to help us publish on the PlayStation Network proper for PS4 and Vita.
If anybody is out there, please consider helping out. Throw the warped code out to help get this game available, because I would love to see that.
もしパブリッシャーが見ていたら、ぜひthrow the warped code out に連絡してください。私もこのゲームが出てほしいです。
Yes, because it should be on a PlayStation platform.
ぜひ PlayStation のプラットフォームにね、対応してますので、ぜひその PlayStation のプラットフォームに出てほしいです。
そうですね、プレイステーションも嬉しいですし、別にそれ以外でも、まあ、Unity でできてますから、他のコンソールもバッチリです。ただ、一つだけ、スマートフォンはやるつもりがない。
So yes, I would be really happy if Sony would publish it. And other platforms are really like really easy to do because it's built in Unity. Just one thing, no, I'm not doing this for smartphones.
You're not doing it for what?
I will not release this on smartphones.
Oh, okay. Oh, really? That's interesting.
This game needs to physical control.
I respect that because there are some games released on smartphone that probably shouldn't be on smartphone. So,
その点では尊敬してます。あのいろいろな、まあ、あのフィジカルコントロールがあの、まあ、必要なゲームがモバイルに出てるから、ちょっとそれはありがたいですね。あのフィジカルコントロール。
So, thank you very much, for joining me, and good luck on getting your game on the PlayStation platform.
来ていただいてありがとうございました。あのぜひあのソニーのプラットフォームに出るように頑張ってください。
はい。Well, I believe, is there anything else that you wanted to tell the people watching at home?
追加のコメントとかありますでしょうか？
そうですね。このバックイン1995を見て、こういうゲーム面白いと思った人は、あなたも32ビットのレトロゲームに挑戦してください。ゲーム開発に。
So, if you like what you saw here, definitely give making a 32-bit retro game a try.
Sure, absolutely. Yes, please do. That's what it's all about.
格闘ゲームとか RPG とかいろいろな今世の中は、ドットの 2D のゲームばっかりだからそれ以外のものを、出してもらうと僕が嬉しいです。
So currently there are a lot of 2D pixel art games and that sort of thing. So if you can make a retro 32-bit 3D fighting game or an RPG, that would make me most happy.
Yeah, it is true. You see a lot of like 2D retro style games.
本当にそうですね。2D の方が多いんですね。
And 3D is more rare.
3D の方が、まあ、リアルなので。
僕が今あの、僕が小さい時に遊んでいたゲーム機はプレイステーション、最初のプレイステーションで、そのゲームがすごく好きだったんで、そういうインディーゲームがもっと増えてくれることに期待しています。
So I played PlayStation first when I was young, and so that's the most nostalgic for me, and I really want to see more of these retro 32-bit games out there.
Oh, wow. That makes me feel very old.
それを聞くとちょっとまあ年取ってるって感じますけど。
Because no me. Because my first system was like you know Atari.
私の方だと Atari が最初でしたけど。
あの世代のあのギャップなので順番だと思います。例えば今の高校生は PlayStation 2とかもしかしたら PSP が初めてかも。
So that's just a bit of a generational gap, I think, and it goes in order. Today's high schoolers would probably have grown up playing PSP and PlayStation 2.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of my viewers talk about how nostalgic they are for like the N64.
私のチーズチャンネルを見てる人も、あのまあ小さい頃 N の64とかやってたなとよく言ってる。
Yeah, so I understand. I am old.
わかりますけど、私は年取ってます。
なんかごめんなさい。
I'm sorry to hear that.
いいよ。Well, thank you very much again for joining me.
本当にありがとうございました。
はい。So we will take a short break and prepare for the next segment, which I'm not sure at this point in time like what's happening. There's some things that are up in the air right now.
I think it's going to be big.
I think it's going to be a big segment that you don't want to miss. Talking about, it's going to be a mighty segment. So, I don't know. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, this is Gun Run. More content to come soon. Hang tight, y'all. We'll be right back.
Supposed to be.
Check 1, 2.
so there's me. Okay. Yeah. I was just checking to see how I look. Okay. It's my hair. There we go. Yeah. Sure. Do you want to start on that one? Yeah. And then start on that, and then we'll go to the other camera. Okay. Hey there everybody, I'm sure you're probably wondering if there was ever going to be any more content on stream. Well, I'm back. It's time yet again for another Man on the Street segment while we fill time before the next segment, which I'm very excited about. It's just that there's so much up in the air in terms of we're trying to find where the people are for the next segment. Of course, I'm talking about Mighty No. 9. Yes, we're going to be hopefully talking with Keiji Inafune very soon. But before we do that, I just wanted to, I guess, I'm going to go around and try to talk to some people here at Tokyo Indie Fest and see if I can score another English interview with your average Japanese person here in Tokyo. So I'm going to see how this goes. So I think we're going to switch cameras now. This is cut off. Okay, so there we go. Now, this is amazing. We're actually using a phone to go live and out on the floor. So that's why it looks a little bit blurry on the cast here. But come with me. And this is Bree, my camera lady. And oh man, that's just a bit choppy. That's just terrible. No, but that's okay. That's what we're dealing with. That's what Indie Fest is all about. It's guerrilla. You get in there. It doesn't matter. Excuse me, sir. Okay, we're gonna see. I don't want to interrupt your discussion, but as you can see, it's getting pretty full here. So let's see if we're 0 for 1. Okay, so could get one there. What about this? Is okay, maybe so who can we talk to here? I don't want to scare people. Hold on, let me talk to these guys.
Wow.
I was like straight up denied. That guy looked at me. He looked at me and then he just walked away. He was just like, no. Wow, that was... I don't know, am I scaring them? Am I scaring them? I hate to say it, but I'm trying to see if there's like a look for like a Japanese person who will speak some English with me. Okay.
ちょっとすみません。英語でインタビューしてもいいですか?
Yes! It's perfect. So I only have one question. What do you think of Tokyo Indie Show, Tokyo Indie Fest so far?
My friend, my friend had a talk session and Abus introduced myself game.
Cool. Which game? Which game are you most excited about?
I play two games. There are games not interesting.
Not interesting? Zenzen?
Yeah. My job is game producer.
Really? You're a game producer? Sugoi! That's awesome. Where do you work? Cool. Well, thank you very much. It's very brave of you to speak English with me. Like a lot, many people will not speak English. So you are very cool and. You worked at EA 2 years ago. Wow, cool.
Well, I speak some coworkers speak English.
I see. See, that's kind of like my Japanese. It's very like a, it's very my. I know Scottish, but I get by. So, but thank you very much again, and enjoy the rest of the show. Yeah, thank you very much. It's beautiful. That was wonderful. I don't even know how we're doing on time. I don't have my phone. Somebody else has a phone. Are we good on time? Okay, yeah. It always feels, you know, like I've been talking for like an hour, and then it's like, oh, like 5 minutes have gone by. I'm like, okay. I think we can find another one. So that was a really cool guy. Like he. Usually, like they'll just answer like one question, and then, like he was down to get talk about like he's working in the industry and all that. It's very cool. I feel very much like the scary foreigner like, with the microphone. Like nobody wants to talk to me. They're definitely avoiding eye contact right now. It's
ちょっとすみません。英語で。インタビューしてもいいですか？
え、ダメ？ダメですか？全然 OK。わかりました。Well, so, alright. I think we're 1 for 2. 1 out of 2 ain't bad. Maybe,
ちょっと、すいません。ちょっと、英語。
Oh, you can speak English! Oh my god! Well, there you go! Well, very cool. So, how are you guys liking the Tokyo Indie Fest?
We're good! We actually came here for you!
You're kidding! I have fans! Oh my god! This is crazy!
And we're periscoping it right now!
That's crazy!
Yes.
So, like, and we're live on the Twitch stream right now.
Oh, hi!
Hi, yes, I think we're on the front page.
What's your name? Angel.
Angel.
Nice to meet you, man!
Nice, this is amazing!
What? Mankind!
Man, everything! I just thought, you thought I was an interesting, foreigner with a microphone.
Gaijin with a microphone.
It's Gaijin. So, that's... this.
Yes. Oh! We love it so far. I mean, we want to check out the new games. I mean, we have some of the ones as apps, like Exxon, and they're out there. And we have Domination. Here we go.
This show is very like guerrilla style, like usually with like PAX and PAX East, the booth is all decked out. We've got like three different stages and everything. Here it's like we got three chairs and a webcam. it's been very interesting and it's been a lot of fun. But hold on, can we get a shot of this guy's shirt? I just want to show Lyric. Yeah, senpai. Yeah. Senpai Lorik. Very cool. Well, thank you very much for coming over. Yes! Can we put the channel like...
It's weeping_angel, A-N-J-E-L. I usually shouldn't miss me, but I mean, I watch you all the time, play Bloodborne, Dark Souls, and Lyric. You know, there are fans that I saw the Gunrun, just playing too. I mean, come on, Twitch, you gotta support your fans.
that's so cool. Like, it's, I love meeting somebody all the way over here in Japan. This is a huge fan of Twitch, more importantly, me. Wow. Well, this is just great. I suppose I won't hold you up much longer, and hopefully we can get a chance to talk.
Look at the speakers.
Yes, it's true. And I love how I totally forgot to like hold the mic over. Like,
no, it's fine. It's fine. But yeah, go enjoy any Tokyo Fest, and we'll just be watching. Okay.
Can we do mirrored output?
Sweet, sweet. Do you know, are you guys going to be at the Twitch party later?
We wanted to, but we didn't really know much information about it. So, we find out more information.
Okay, I think hopefully we can get you the information. I don't have the information right now, but... Gunrun is the guy to talk to, so... well, it's wonderful meeting you, and hold on. Yeah, here, give me a hug. Oh! Yes. This is incredible. I don't know what else to say. I think that'll...
Please tell me about the story about when you were at 4-H in Japan. Oh, why you so lazy.
Oh my god, it's true. For the viewers at home, I used to live in Japan. I lived in Japan for about 10 months back in 99-2000. And I was a student it was a student exchange program. And I missed quite a few days of school. I'm not gonna get into that, but anyway, the guy who was in charge of like the program, he like called me in and he basically gave me a stern talking to, and I mean, he just flat out told me, he was just like, he asked me, he's like, so why are you missing these so many days of school? I was like, I gave him all my excuses. I was like, you know, it's, you know, my brain, it's just, I'm just tired, you know, I'm tired. You know, and he was just like, you are lazy. he was like, you are lazy, ne? And I was like, yeah, okay, lazy. That's pretty harsh, but yeah. So, you know what? You know what I say? Yeah, look at me now, okay? I'm going places. So, yes. So, thank you very much again. This is... You too. Nice meeting you guys. Yes! That's just crazy, absolutely crazy. I suppose that'll do it for this segment. I hope Gunrun is there. I think he's there. He looks busy. Anyway, we're probably gonna go to the shot again of the wide shot of the hall, hopefully Keiji Inafune is around with the latest build of Mighty Number 9. Which is basically the next Mega Man game that everyone's like super hyped for, myself included. I can't wait to see the game. It's actually playable here, from what I understand, but I just haven't had the time to get over there. So... There's been a lot of downtime between the interviews. It's just... It's basically like three people here, like with Twitch. By the way, and the people organizing the event have been super helpful, up to and including Bree, holding the camera right now, my camera lady. So thank you, Bree. And I'm sorry that we did not let you play Downwell. I feel very bad about that now. We should have. We did you wrong. Sorry. But anyway, we're going to be back very shortly. I swear, hopefully with Mighty Number 9 and Keiji Inafune right after this. We'll be right back. And hopefully now Gunrun has cut. Hello, ladies and gentlemen watching at home. Welcome back to Tokyo Indie Fest 2015, the first Tokyo Indie Fest. I am honored to be joined by Mr. Keiji Inafune from Comcept. And of course, Jeff is here as always translating. We are here, of course, to take a look at Mighty No. 9. How are you doing today, Keiji?
まずあのインディフルネさんあの来ていただいてありがとうございます。今日はあの期限はどうですかね。
そうですね。あのマイティーム人いっぱいいるんでね、期限いいですよ。
So there are plenty of people here to see Mighty No. 9. I'm feeling pretty good.
Yes. It seems to have gotten quite a bit of attention on the internet as well. I'm sure everybody, including me, is very excited for the release of this game. I can't wait to see.How it's coming along.
まあここでもあのネット上でも結構盛り上がっていますので、あの私も楽しみにしてますけど、今日は超楽しみにしています。このゲームを見てみて。
そうですね。本当にあの発売日も決まったんで、あのやっとあの皆さんにお届けできるっていうことでね。で僕もあの、まあ、作りながらあのめちゃめちゃこう発売楽しみなんですけど、あのみんなに遊んでもらうことが最も楽しみです。
So we finally locked down our release date and we're continuing development, and even I'm excited to see this get into the hands of players and see them actually check it out.
Yeah, I think it's going to be huge. It was crazy to me when I found out that there's already a Mighty No. 9 show in production as well. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, 私もこれが結構売れると思うんですけど、あのびっくりしたことは、あのすでにアニメとかもあの開発しているので、あのなんかの意見とかはありますでしょうか？
そうですね。あの売れてもらったら嬉しいなと思うんですけど、あのゲームを作るっていうよりも、あの自分自身はこのコンテンツですね。もうコンテンツを作るっていう。だからゲームに限らずいろんなものにこのマイティナンバーナインが広がっていくっていうことを望んでるんで、その方向にこう進みつつあるんで、あの、すごく楽しみですよ、僕は。
So I really hope it sells well too, but as far as the Mighty No. 9 product, more than the game, I like expanding the property and just getting it really out there.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely, the character of Mighty No. 9 seems like a perfect fit for, putting, you know, making his own show really giving the world that he's in more detail.
Mighty No. 9のベクがあの、まあ、アニメとかだとぴったりの、あの、あの主人公とかになると思うんですから、あの、まあ、素晴らしいと思います。
そうですね。あの、もともと僕はあのキャラクターデザイナー出身なんで、そのキャラクターにこう魂を命を吹き込むっていうのが、まあ、得意なんでね。やっぱりキャラクターが生き生き動いていく形のあの主人公であり、それがゲームになっていくっていうのを目指して作ったんで、あの僕も楽しみですね。
So I started in character design. I really like breathing life into those characters and seeing how they animate and move and really just bringing them to life.
Yes, I think, and that's as we've seen some of the characters that you've made in the past. They are still beloved by everybody. So, just gets me all the more excited for Mighty No. 9.
まあ、あの以前作ったキャラクターでもそういうあの命があの感じるので、これも楽しみにしています。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
So, Josh, should we take a look at the game itself?
早速見てみましょうか。
はい、じゃあちょっと。
So, and Keiji Inafune is going to play Mighty No. 9. I feel this is like magic. I can't believe this.
この瞬間はちょっとマジックを感じました、今。
博士、サンダー博士というですね、マイティナンバーナインの、サポートをする博士ですね。日本人なんですよ、サンダーっていう。だからあのすごくやっぱ日本の技術みたいなもこの世界の中にあるっていう形ですね。
So this is Professor Sanda who supports the character of Mighty No. 9, and he's really expanding the techniques and the technology of Japan around the world in this story, in this fiction.
Oh, okay, cool.So this is a sort of a stage select.
Yes. さんのステージがあって、あのすごいあの多彩ないろんな遊びができるステージになってます。まずはあの最初のステージちょっとお見せしたいなと思ってます。
So there are lots of stages in there with different ways to play each stage, but I'm going to show you the first one to start.
Sure, that makes perfect sense. And here we go.
じゃあ行きましょう。
System's ready.
これはあのホワイト博士、ドクターホワイトですね、うん、これはあのサンダ博士と友達なんですけど、ベックを作った博士ですね、うん、
So this is Dr. White who helped Professor Sanda and helped make Beck the main character.
Dr. White though. Sounds very familiar.
なんか似てる話ですね。
よし。So A to jump, X.
それこれジャンプ。ジャンプ攻撃っていうのはまあ普通にこういうゲームではありがちなんですけど、これはあの空中でもこういうダッシュで動けるっていう、これあのマイティナンバーナインの特徴ですね。
So you can attack while jumping in plenty of games, but this one characteristic of Mighty No. 9 is the ability to dash in midair as well.
Very cool.
これただダッシュするだけじゃなくてですね、あの敵を吸収するときに使う能力ですね。
So this isn't just a dash, you can also use it to attack enemies as well.
Oh, wow.
Has declared a countrywide state of emergency.
Cool.
This based on reports of haywire robots rampaging out of control in all 52 states. And being told we have a comment from Gregory Graham, CEO of Cherry Dynamics. Cherry Dyne, of course, being the world's leading robot manufacturer.
彼も登場人物の中ではですね、まあ、あの主要な人物でですね、あのこのチェリー社っていうですね、あのロボットの作ってる会社のあの偉い人なんですけど、あのいろいろこう謎を彼は決めてます。
So this is one of the other main characters in the game, and he works for this company that creates lots of robots, so he's well respected, but there's an air of mystery about him as well.
Seems to be a very deep story to the game already.
物語が結構深そうなんですけど。
そうですね。あの悪いやつがいて、そいつを倒せばいいっていう単純なもんではなくて、ちょっとこういろんな複雑なストーリーが入ってます。
So it's not just about having a bad guy that you have to defeat. There's a little bit of complexity to it as well.
That's very cool.
もともとベックの仲間だったあのマイティナンバーズがですね、暴走をし始めて、それをベックが止めなきゃいけないっていうことです。
So, Beck being Mighty Number 9, there are other Mighty Numbers who have come before him, and they've kind of gone wild, and Beck has to stop them.
Okay. I'm guessing so. There have been 8 other Mighty Numbers that he might have to take care of.
Mighty Number が他の、あの、8人というかありますよ。
これ9番目の、あの、ナンバーなんで、1から8までっていうことです。
So him being the ninth, there's numbers 1 through 8 to fight.
I see. It's all coming together. So, oh, there's an enemy. Nice.
敵が出たんですね。
So, there was the... I saw the 100%. So, is there like a grading system?
100% が出たんですけど、あの、なんかのグレードがあります。
これゆっくりやってると、今 10% って。だから、敵が吸収できる状態になって、早いタイミングで、あの吸収しないと 100% 出ないんですね。100% を続けるとあのコンボっていう形でですね、2コンボ、今2コンボになりましたけど、これをこうつなげていくことができ
る。
So this is all about timing. If you attack the enemy too slowly, it'll drop down to say 10%. But if you attack them at the right time quickly, it's 100%, and you can chain those together as you just saw for combos.
Very cool. Which is So it's not just about beating the level, but also I noticed that you can get grades on the level itself, like S grade or A grade. So very cool.
Stage の成績は見たもう見たんですけど、あのただステージをクリアすることじゃなくて、あの他のコンボとかのありますよね。
そうですね。あのステージただクリアするだけだと、あの D とかですね、評価が低くなっちゃいますね。だからあの評価の A とか S とか欲しければですね。やっぱりあの要は 100% を続けていくとかですね、ダメージ食らわないとか、そういう割と自分にあのなんていうかな、課題を課すことができますね。
So yeah, if you just clear the stage, you'll end up with something like a D. If you do it with plenty of combos and good timing, then you'll end up getting a higher grade. Or if you don't take damage on a particular stage, for instance.
I can see how people kind of like me, the gamers like me, you know, kind of like the completionist, you know, I can see how people could get very obsessed with, you know, getting 100% on every stage.
私のようなゲーマーが、あの、 これだとあの 100% 出ないとダメみたいなあのこだわりが出るみたいな、
うん、そうですね、あの 100% 出ないとクリアできないわけじゃないんで、うん、あの別にそれにこだわらなければ、まあ言ってしまえばこれずっと打ってるとあのこうほら倒すこともできるんですね、
うん、
今までのゲームのようにですね、別に吸収したくないっていう人はですね、
うん、
倒していけばいいっていう。
So you don't have to get 100% on everything to clear it, obviously, but there are people who will do that, and you know, there are people who will want to just play the game and have fun with it too.
Sure. Yep. Everybody has different ways of enjoying the game, and so this kind of gives more options, I think.
Play just about any way you'd like.
I was wondering how you're going to get across.
どうやって渡ればいいかと思ったんだけど
飛べます、飛べます
飛べる、
I'm gonna fly
すごいよSo the fireball above his head, that symbol, is that when you have a good combo going?
頭の上のアイコンはあのコンボで出るんですか？
あの敵を吸収するときに敵があの何色で吸収できるかによってですね、スキルが手に入るんですね、うん、貫通する弾であったりとか、ちょっと自分が速くなったりとか、そういうスキルを手に入れることで、あのここね、青いのがつきます。これだとちょっと足が速くなります。
うーん、 OK。
So each enemy has a different color, and when you attack them, you know...
そう
弾が、
wow.
So for instance, green makes you faster, and red will increase the size of your bullets, etc.
Gotcha. So it depends on the type of enemy defeated.
じゃあ、あの、敵の種類によっても。
そうですね。
I see. So...
And there's a time limit.
と、その時間内で、この緑が切れちゃうんで、これで切れちゃう。
So you're faster for as long as that timer is up on the screen.
I gotcha.So there seem to be a lot of incentives to sort of, you know, keep your combo up and you know, kind of, you know.
そのコンボと敵をあの連続で倒すことがあの、まあ、目的ですね。そのスキルをあの、溜まるように。
スキルがあった方が倒しやすくなるんで、でまあ、こういうアイテムが落ちてるんで、そこで拾うとあのエネルギー回復したりとか。
So obviously having those skills will make it easier to kill enemies, and the enemies will also drop items as well.
It's cool. There it is, the dash. You can climb up ladders. Oh, yarimashita. But I definitely like the art design of the game so far. It looks very, very gorgeous.
このアートとデザインが結構優れてると思います。
そうですね、あの割と僕はあのキャラクターデザイナーなんで、その辺はこだわりますよね。
I focus on that a lot, being a character designer.
Yeah, it comes through. And you can also see like how many different characters are in the game. Like Dr.
で、そしてあの登場人物のあの数字が結構あの出るんですよね。うん。
うわ。
オープニングステージの、ボスキャラクターなんです
ね。うん。
This is the boss of the opening stage.
Round Digger. ロボット。うわ。うわ。So there's this life bar. うん。うわ。I get the feeling, that you're not playing as good as you probably can, because you want to show people, you don't want to give away how to beat the boss, too easily, right?
このボスを倒せばあのネタバレでちょっと、優しくしてるのかな。
そうですね、これはオープニングステージなんで、あのみんな慣れてもらうという意味ではそんな難しくしてないですね、
うん、Because this...
あの敵吸収しなきゃいけないんで、あのただ倒すだけじゃなくて、この吸収しなかったら倒せないという形、
うん、
そうです。
吸収できる状態で今これ吸収して、
うわすごい。
すべて吸収したらクリアと。これはすべてのボスに言えることですね。
So we wanted to make this a little bit easy for the players to get used to it, but even this boss can be attacked at a certain time. And if you kill all the enemies with that timing in the level, you know, you'll get extra, a better ranking.
Oh, B.
B. Dame,
dame.
No good, no good.
それはいけないよ. And that's why I think you can tell that you were, you know, you were faking it. You were playing not as good as
you. 今の本気じゃないよね。
説明しながらなんで、
そう、
わざと当たってみたりとか、わざとダメージ食らってみたり。
I'm so sorry.
I was speaking. I couldn't focus.
I apologize. 申し訳ありません。
申し訳ありません。
But the game is looking very cool so far. I missed. What is the release date for the game?
ここまでは結構優れてると思うんですけど、そのリリースの発売日はいつでしょうか？
皆さんにすごく待たせてるんですけど、やっと決まってですね、9月の15日ですね。これ全米発売ということで、アメリカが15日に、9月15日発売で、世界的には9月18日の発売という形になります。
So, we finally announced the release date. We've kept you all waiting. In America, it will be September 15th, and okay. That's for all of America. And for the rest of the world, September 18th.
Okay, September 15th.
アメリカだけちょっとね、エコひいきした感じがあるんですけど、実はですね、これ、キックスターター自体がまあアメリカの、そのものっていうかですね、とこで、キックスターターでやっぱり、こうお金をこう支援していただいた方のやっぱり7割が北米なんですね、カナダ、アメリカなんですよ、だからその人たちにまずこう感謝の気持ちでっていうつもりがあって、ちょっとだけ早くっていう形ですよ。
So we are treating the Americans a little bit special, but we used Kickstarter for this project, and so 70% of our backers came from America and Canada, North America. So we are trying to give them a little bit of a present for that support.
Well, we, as an American, I want to say we appreciate it.
アメリカ人として感謝しています。
But we are, yes, huge fans of your work, and I can't wait to play the game.
イルフレム様の作品が大ファンで楽しみにしています。
そう。ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
Yes, and thank you very much for joining us today.
どうも来ていただいてありがとうございました。
Yes. Is there anything else you want to tell people out there watching?
ツイッチを見ている方に追加のコメントとかはありますでしょうか？
はい。本当にね、ゲームが好きで、特にマイティナンバーナインのような、なんていうかな、日本の昔ながらのゲームが大好きな人たちにですね、楽しんでもらえる、ものになってるんで、そういう人たちに喜んでもらうためにですね、僕たち頑張ってるんで、本当にもうちょっと待ってもらったら、マイティナンバーナイン遊びますんで、楽しみに待ってください。
I really hope people who like playing these classic Japanese games in this sort of style, I really want to please them. So I really look forward to them enjoying the game.
Yes, I personally feel like classic style games are the best.
まあ個人的にこのようなクラシックなゲームが一番いいと思いますけど。
So.
はい、ありがとうございます。
はいはい。Thank you very much again, Keiji Inafune.
どうもありがとうございました。
Yes, and I suppose we will take a short break and get ready for the next segment. But That's all for now from us, I guess. So, thank you.
以上です。どうもありがとうございました。
Hey, welcome back to the stream here. It's Man for Man vs. Game. I was so nervous during that last segment. I didn't even realize that we actually were done for the day. So I actually, I know it's kind of shitty of me to do this, but we're done. We were just supposed to cast from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. We put in our time, and we're done. We really do. There's nothing more to say, really. We actually have another full day of interviews and content to bring you from Tokyo Indie Fest tomorrow, though. And it's going to be the same time. So 6 p.m. Pacific. It's 10 a.m. in Japan. Anybody watching from Japan? But that's going to do it for today. Tomorrow, there are some very, very cool people that we'll be talking with. I know the one I am looking forward to the most for tomorrow is we'll be talking with a guy named Ricky. Ricky just recently made a Famicom game. And I mean, like, the old 8-bit, like, Famicom games. He just made an amazing game. And it features music from, like, some of the best chiptune artists out there. It's going to be very cool. We've kind of saved him for the last, but very much looking forward to it. Sorry to, you know, get your hopes up and then just dash them on the rocks like that and have to come back and say that we're done for the day, but that's pretty much it. So this is Man from Tokyo Indie Fest, day one, signing off. We'll see you around for day two. Take care out there. We'll talk to you later.
Used to think I was someone special till you knew my